there, everybody. I see that hardly any of you left, so wonderful that you were so willing to stick around. There are other things to do in the park, just so you know. Well, thank you. It's so good to see you, too. Everybody here knows that we've already done one story. Are we ready for a second?
Yeah!
I love how energetic everybody is. This story that I'm going to do today is a mashup of a beloved bedtime story and a very profitable licensing agreement. This story is Cinderpool. Yeah, I'm glad you think that's funny, kid. All right. Let's see. I did this one. There's a doodle in here somewhere. Oh, right there. It's me and Wolvie. It's so cute. Once upon a time. They told me I had to do it every time, so we're just all gonna say it together, okay? On three. One, two, three.
Once upon a time.
I said together. You were way off. Nobody was very good at that. Upon a time, once, Cinderpool lived in an enchanted mansion with her step professor and her step mutants. The biggest step mutant, Colossus, was very bossy, was always making up silly rules like, don't put your initials on other people's leftovers in the fridge. Put the toilet seat back down and, for the love of Feige, stop hanging your underwear from the ceiling fan. What is wrong with you? The other step mutant, Negasonic Teenage Warhead, was always texting and rolling her eyes. She was so Gen Z. Both of these step mutants were very jealous because Cinderpool had a much, much larger fan base. Yeah, you can tell. Nobody showed up for Colossus. One day, an expendable non-union extra went running in front of the mansion grounds, screaming. King Thanos was planning the biggest battle of Phase 3, which we all know is the last important phase. Yeah. Cinderpool desperately wanted to go to the big battle. He went to Colossus and begged, but Colossus said,
no, it is too dangerous, and Cinderpool is not a good part of the team.
Then Colossus ripped apart Cinderpool's favorite and cleanest costume, and Negasonic blasted it with her mind powers, which was so cool. She's so Gen Z. On fleek, no cap, Sigma. Cinderpool was distraught and very exposed. He was crying, stumbling out onto the mansion grounds for dramatic effect. But suddenly, he saw in the air what began to form was a sparkle circle. It grew bigger and bigger, and out of that sparkle circle stepped Cinderpool's fairy godmutant. Go through the, oh, he went, okay, there we go. Oh, fairy godmutant Wolverine! I desperately want to go to the big battle, but my step mutants destroyed my costume.
Shut up.
He said lovingly.
What?
In the story, my costume's destroyed and I can't go to the battle without it.
Nobody cares about your costume. Well, get another one. Stop whining.
With that sage life advice, Cinderpool ran to the wardrobe department and grabbed a new costume from Stunts because they're always cleaner and more flexible. Thanks, Doug. And then he went back to his fairy godmutant and said, let's go! And away they went to the battle. Cinderpool was late because he stopped at 7-Eleven for chimichangas, but they don't sell chimichangas there anymore, so he had to go to three other gas stations and eventually just gave up. And he showed up to the battle and the Avengers were winning! Captain America looked so cool. He looked around for his fairy god mutant Wolverine, who was...
I'm going to Pim's.
Okay. Well, anyway, Cinderpool surveyed the battlefield to see how he could help. He saw, right on the stairs of an alien ship, a single gold glove. Cinderpool picked that glove up and said, "I wonder if this fits," and put that glove on. After some buzzing, whirring, and clicking, it was a perfect fit. Tony Stark looked over and started screaming, "Take that off! What are you doing?" All the other Avengers started running too. Tony's still over there crying. "No, this is my moment. I don't want to be in this franchise anymore. Do not snap." So Cinderpool snapped. Both physically and mentally. Yeah, he does that all the time. He actually just kept snapping. It was awesome. People were disappearing, reappearing. They were crying. Dogs were falling out of the sky. It was a big thing. But eventually, Cinderpool stopped. Everyone was back. Except, of course, the people that talk at the movie theater. We didn't want them back. Yeah, you know, you were all there. Cinderpool was the real hero. At this moment, all the Avengers tackled Cinderpool to the ground, ripped the glove off of him, blah, blah, blah. When they remade the movie years later, Tony Stark gets to be the big sacrificial hero, and it goes on to become the most profitable film in the entire Feige universe, the FCU. Did I add a letter again? But it's okay, because Cinderpool went on to start his own film franchise, which will be way more profitable, and eventually they will invite Cinderpool back for the Avengers Endgame 2, Electric Boogaloo. Oh. And it's gonna be so cool. Sorry, anyway, thank you all. That is the end. The end game, it's a joke. Okay, thank you all for joining us. We'll see you at the next story time with Deadpool.
Exact same theme park tickets for less, no catch, at Undercover Tourist.